city daylight. I spent a long time in the dark, felt good saying goodbye. Waking up to a brand new heart. And if you're sleeping like I used to be, in a grave that holds you tight, there's a savior calling. Promising a brand new life, he's saying.
Listen.
Rise up in that amazing grace. I'll sleep, but won't you come away? Come away.
Rise up and come out of that grave. Probably gonna get so much trouble for this, but it's okay. Because I love it so much. Happy Thursday, guys. Oh my gosh. Wake up, sleeper, open your eyes. Oh my goodness. We're going to leave the past at the door. Hope y'all enjoyed that little mini concert. It's over now. Oh my goodness. I love that song so much. Anyways, happy Thursday. Happy stinking Thursday, y'all. We are making it. We are making it. Let me go ahead and let y'all know that I will not be on here tomorrow morning, okay? I have other plans where I'm going to be leaving, so I can't do it. I can't do it tomorrow, but I will be back Monday. I will be back Monday, so bear with me. Y'all have a good weekend, okay? All right, so today we're on day 84. 84, guys. 100 Days to Brave by Annie F. Downs. We are on day 84. Be generous with your words. Be generous with your words. Proverbs 16:24 says, gracious words are like a honeycomb. Sweetness to the soul and health to the body. If you're watching me live, give me hashtag #1. If you're watching the replay, give me hashtag #2. All right. And we are going to go ahead and just dive right into this. I love that scripture. Gracious words are like a honeycomb, sweetness to the soul and health to the body. Man, brave people take God's word and speak love into the lives of others. Huh. We just soak that first sentence that Annie tells us in because it's so true. Brave people take God's word and speak love into the lives of others. Brave people let God love them and know they are equipped for all the ways to use their words to speak love. Today's verse is so beautiful to me and so true. Have you ever been around someone whose words are just great? And I mean great as in G-R-A-T-E, like irritating. Have you ever been around someone whose words just irritate, right? We can use our words to hurt others, to be negative, to gossip, and to complain. Amen. We see more than our fair share right here on Facebook, right? Or we can be brave enough to step out into a negative, cynical world where people want to hear gossip and negativity, and instead we can be generous with our words and use them to bring life. Huh. God can use you to your words to bring life. To bring life. If we are focused on that, if our goal day in and day out is to be generous and gracious, speaking love with our words, our negative mindsets and habits will fall away. Think about it. If we're focused on that, think about what you're focused on. If we are focused on that, if our goal day in and day out is to be generous and gracious, speaking love with our words, our negative mindsets and habits will fall away. The cussing will stop because it doesn't fit into who you want to be, right? It'll quit. It'll stop. The sarcasm will slow. It'll slow because you can't imagine hurting someone else with your words, even if it is unintentional, right? The inappropriate jokes may still come into your mind, but not so much out of your mouth anymore. Those things will start to stop, right? When we put God's word in diligently and routinely, the lesser things fall away. Guys, it's so true. I say this all the time. I tell my kids, I tell people, look, the more you put this word in, get this in you, the other stuff will just fall off. It'll fall away. Man, it's this word because it's alive and it's powerful. It's living. It's breathing. It's cutting. I'm telling you, it is separating. That's what the word of God does. The more you get it down inside of you, all that yucky stuff, all that worldly stuff, it just starts to fade away. And you start filling your life with God's word. And God's word will clean you up. It is amazing, but it will do it. You got to feed yourself that word, right? God makes us new again and again, and we can be intentional and generous with our words to ourselves, to each other, and to God. I hope today that you will write a note to anyone, to people who need some words of life poured into their hearts. I hope that you will stand up for people who can't stand up for themselves. And I hope you will think before you speak, choosing words that are gifts of light, not ones that cause death. Think about the words that we put out on social media. Right? Ouch, I know. How many times have we typed something out and hit that delete, 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 delete? I've been there. Delete it all back out. It's probably why the Lord just had to make me just get rid of a whole Facebook account and create a whole new. I needed that reset. I needed that time off. Touch my brain. Touch my mind. Maybe it's nobody else, but it sure was me. I can only speak for myself, but I know I needed it. Right? We need to be intentional. We need to think before we speak. Are you speaking life and hope to somebody? Are you speaking death? I don't care how angry you are. I don't care what they did. It doesn't matter. What is coming out of your mouth? Right? We can't control what other people say and do, but we can control our reaction. We can control what we say. Right? Let's think before we speak, guys. Think. Choose words that are gifts of light. And not ones that cause death. Man, I know that's hard. I know when someone lashes out at you and says something, you want to cut them right back, man. You want to come back. You got something that's right there on the tip of your tongue, man. You want to just rip them from one end to another. I get it. Man, that Holy Spirit will put you in check, though. Hold up, Emily. You don't do that. Holy Spirit lives inside. Think before you let that mouth open up. Think before you mouth off. Think before you say something that's going to cut somebody that's speaking death. Stop it. Because we are children of the light. We are children of the day, right? That's what the word says. We are no longer children of the night and darkness and death. We've been bought with a price. We belong to Jesus Christ. We are not our own. So these words that are coming out of our mouths have to please the Father. Think before you speak. Speak words of hope and love. Man, think before you speak. Friend, be brave. Be brave. Be different in a world that uses words to hurt. We see it everywhere. I think that's why it's so easy, because we see it so much. It just, it's in us. And that's why we have to spend so much time in God's word and let that fill us and get all the other junk out, right? Use your words to heal, and use them often. Use them often. Give those words of life, the words found in scripture, to as many people as you can. Man, do it today. Do it today. You can. You can do it. I don't care what that devil says. He lies, you know. And he'll tell you you ain't got it in you. You're just who you are. You'll always be that way. He's a liar. He is a liar. You got to know who you are in Christ. God knows you. He created you. He knows what's down deep inside, what he can place there and get rid of all of that other junk. And you can change. You can speak words of life and not of death. You can have words that are sweet and healing to other people and to yourself. Now, maybe you need to take the time to speak some good healing words to yourself. Look yourself in the mirror and speak some good words. Emily, you're a masterpiece. Ephesians 2:10 says that you are a masterpiece created in Christ Jesus for good works. Man, you were created in your mother's womb. Tell yourself. Speak to yourself. Man, Jesus loves me. He died on the cross for me. He conquered death, hell, and the grave for me. He loves me. He gave me a hope and a future. He's lighting my path. Man, do you know what all God does for you? Speak some healing words over your life today. I will live and not die. I will speak goodness and not death. I will speak healing words and not death over my soul or anyone else's. Lord, you're going to touch my mouth. You're going to touch my mind today. Renew it. And I'm going to speak the things that you have me to speak today. I'm going to get your word down inside of me. Speak those things. You can do it. You can do it. Her Be Brave challenge for today says, write a note to someone you love who has been important to you lately. If you can, put it in the mail so he or she gets a good piece of surprise snail mail. Nobody gets snail mail anymore. The regular mail, right? A handwritten card, note, letter, something. Make the time to try to do that today. Do it soon. And write a letter to somebody who's just, man, someone that you love and that has just really helped you, right? Spoke words of life and encouraging things to you. And let them know how important they are to you. And thank them, right? Such a good one for today, guys. Such a good one. Be generous with your words. But let's be careful about what words we're being generous with, right? Think before you speak today. Y'all have a wonderful Thursday. Be blessed. Oh my goodness. Smile. It's a wonderful day. Have a great weekend. Man, have a wonderful weekend. I will not be here tomorrow, so have a wonderful Friday, Saturday, and Sunday. I'm going to be with some teenagers, some youth, and we're going to be traveling. We're going to be in the mountains. So y'all say a prayer for us for safe travels and that God would just show up and have a wonderful, wonderful experience with these young people, something that they will never forget. That's what we're praying, that God just comes in and just does a mighty work in their life this weekend. So I will see y'all Monday on the EMJ Daily. Bye, guys.